Dear participants of this Achal sponsored faculty development program, you know the intention of this faculty development program is to make the education institution faculty members to have an overview of 3D printing as well as advancement as well as applications of 3D printing, so that you can start 3D printing in your campus. So you can establish hub for 3D printing. You can do a lot of research work in 3D printing. You encourage your students to do projects on 3D printing, because this is going to be the manufacturing of the future, right? So I request all the participants, whether it could be a faculty members or it could be some of the PG students are attending the program. So this is an ideal opportunity for you to learn 3D printing. Take this to your students. Do a lot of projects. You can create a lot of funding opportunities through the various funding agencies. So nowadays, as far as any sort of engineering, whether it is a computer science engineering or biomedical engineering or mechanical engineering or electrical engineering, you can see the various applications of 3D printing. So you can apply for the funding agencies in your domain related to 3D printing, right? So now I'll explain the overview of 3D printing, about the future applications of 3D printing. 3D printing, as you know, so far it is mainly focused on automobile industries. So 21.2%, the data as per 2013, focus on automobile industries. 15% for medical industries. You know, now after this COVID, this 15%, now people are starting only for medical applications. You know, the current statistics is it is going to be more than 30% are used for medical applications nowadays. Lot of diseases are coming, lot of viruses are coming. So your 3D printing is right platform for you to solve all these issues. As far as any industries are concerned, Altium Technologies is there, then Brahma 3, Think 3D. So these are the pioneers, the major companies as far as 3D printing technology is concerned. You know, the motor vehicles, as I mentioned, is 31.7% contribution. So this is for the Indian scenario. Right, the consumer products is 18.4%. If you see medical application, it's just 8.8%. It's the whole data. But if you compare the statistics, even in India also, a lot of biomedical industries, they are using 3D printing as the ideal platform. The olden days, you know, the used to have a molding process, right? Suppose if you want to manufacture a remote like this, right? So you need a mold. Right, you have to create a mold, right? Then only you can take to the particular molding machines. So this requires a lot of time for creating the mold. Thanks to 3D printing technologies, nowadays you don't need the mold. You can, if you want your product, say I want to have a remote like this, I can able to produce this remote in say 1 hour. So it is possible because of 3D printing technologies. Every year, you can see there is a society called AMSI, Additive Manufacturing Society of India. Their headquarters is in Bangalore. Every year, they organize the exhibition. AMSI, they organize the exhibition. There you can see all the international manufacturers, Indian manufacturers, they will put their stall and they will display their products. And this is the one product which launched in 2014, completely the 3D printed bicycle. You know, all the components are 3D printed, plastic as well as metallic components. So all these are 3D printed, right? After 3D printing, this entire bicycle is being assembled. So this is an innovation where we can integrate both plastics, I mean both polymer as well as metal in the 3D printing process. You know, India nowadays, they focus on this Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, right, to make self-reliant India. So that is our part of our FD, our Atal FDP also, to make our nation self-reliant. All the products will be manufactured indigenously. You don't need to search for suppliers. You don't need to go for global suppliers. So all the products will be manufactured all the subcomponents will be manufactured. Everything will be done within our country. It's completely indigenization. So this possible only with the help of 3D printing technologies. And 3D doodler is actually 3D pen. You know, children, they'll be using this 3D pen. Right here, this is the base for any sort of 3D printing. You can see you can make your Eiffel Tower using the 3D pen. Right? You can use your pen, whatever creativity you have, you can make any sort of products within a shorter duration of time. Right? There is a bird or something, you know, animal model which you want to do. So all these things will assist in teaching learning process also. Right? Majority of our teachers, faculty members for this STDP. So you will be interested in creating some products for your students' visualization. Nowadays people are talking about augmented reality, virtual reality. You might have heard ARVR, augmented reality, virtual reality. ARVR is a separate one. Now everything, we are marching towards Industry 4.0. You know, Industry 4.0, this comprises all the elements of IoT, augmented reality, virtual reality, 3D printing is there. This comprises recent developments which are in the field of additive manufacturing also. So this is Industry 4.0 is a collective, or what you call it, a mixture of all the elements. Right? So here, this is a 3D pen. So this is like you'll be having a plastic thread. You can see from the picture, there is a plastic thread. And this plastic thread is made up of ABS, acrylonitrile butadiene styrene, ABS, or it could be a PLA, polylactic acid. Or you can use TPU, thermal polyurethane. You can also use this TPU. So this TPU, this is melted at the end so that you can be able to move your pen up and down so that you can be able to get the desired object. This is like your glue gun. You know, children, they will play with the glue gun for their project. So you can do the scaling, say 1:10 or something. You can do the scale or 1:1000. Right? This is like a glue gun. You can 3D print this. So this 3D pen, you can, it's a very, very cheaper, even the cost of 1,000 or 2,000, you can purchase a 3D pen. Right? This 3D pen you can use for your classroom teaching also. Right? Instead of going for directly for a 3D printing, if you have some 3D pen, right, you can have a pen picture of all these things, then you can take it for a 3D printing. So this is really useful for your teaching purpose. This 3D printing, this is used for studying, say a tire, right? This assembly, how this functionality is there. You can create a model, you can study this entire body mechanism. So how the nerves, how the veins are functioning, right? So all these things you can study with the help of 3D printer. You know, the olden days, right, the people were afraid of using 3D printing because they thought robotics, right? So though robotics is an emerging area, cost-wise, this robotics is not feasible. Because if you see that, the involvement of economics, as far as Indian industries is concerned, the main drawback is the cost-benefit ratio. If you purchase a robot, how this is going to be used in a factory shop. But however, if you have a 3D printing mechanism, you can have the provision to print different items. So here, there is a sample, a titanium central beam. So this is not possible with the help of the traditional manufacturing process. Again, this Airbus mid bracket. So you can also 3D print this. The cyclists or the motorists, they will be interested in wearing the right helmet for their head. So here, to have a complete feel of that, your helmet should be able to withstand lift and drag forces, right? You need a fantasy helmet. You need a different helmet for your head. So for that, 3D printed helmets will be the future. Like, this will scan your head, and based on your head dimension, you can be able to create a 3D printed helmet, right? Again, you can see this helmet, they are going to test in the wind tunnel, considering the drag and lift forces. So this they will manufacture, then you can fit in your head. So like that, this is really an ideal platform to customize the traditional items. The traditional items, suppose you purchase a helmet, what you will do, you will directly put. But instead of that, you have the provision to 3D print your helmet. So that option is there. So you need to explore the possibility or feasibility of going for that. No, the ladies will be very fond of wearing jewels, right? The bangles or bands or rings, right? The ornaments, they'll be interested in having different varieties, right? The ladies, they go to a jewelry shop, they take lot of time, you know, they go to the catalog and they see some of the models and still they are not satisfied, they go to another shop. Nowadays, in all the jewelry shop, even Tata or whatever the jewelry jobs, what they are doing is that they have a 3D printer, right? They have a 3D scanner. So this 3D scanner, this will measure the your finger size or your size. So it will capture that. Then this will automatically create a CAD model. And this CAD model will be 3D printed so that you can get the rings or you can get the jewels as per your requirement. So no need to go to the catalog. You can see, you can visualize how this going to be fit in your ear or it could be on your finger. So thanks to 3D printing technology, this is going to be the future market for the Indian industries. Right, in alignment with our our team area for our Atal FDP, now we are focusing on bio printing, organ printing, right? I'll give an interesting case study for the Paralympic. You know, Paralympic is connected for the physically challenged person. A person who is playing a basketball, is very difficult for him to sit and he has to move from one post to another post. It's very difficult for him to move from one location to another location. Considering the ergonomics aspect, he cannot sit comfortably. So what the mechanism is done by the scientists is that they have created a CAD model of these seats. So after creating a CAD model of these seats, right, they have 3D printed that seat, right, in alignment so that they can do the trial and error. They can have n number of iterations in the design software. So after design, they'll be taking to the 3D printing. So in that way, this is really a boon for the persons who are taking the Paralympics. So in that aspect, this is a really ideal platform for them. Again, in alignment with our team area of this Atal FDP, so this is for organ printing. Nowadays, research is going on creating synthetic skin. Sometimes fire accidents happen and the person's skin may be burned out. So it takes a lot of time for him to come back to normal conditions. So this synthetic skin is the ideal one where if there is any fire accident, so you can be able to 3D print the skin artificially. And nowadays, after this pandemic, lot of medical devices are needed. So it could be a nebulizer, or it could be some simple valves, it could be a tube or some injection or syringe. So all these medical devices, you can 3D print them. Especially if you see the army camps, those days, you know, army, they'll be in some remote location. It's very difficult for them to get their stores, to get the consumables. Nowadays in army, what they are doing is that there is a base camp, and in the base camp they carry this 3D printer. Suppose if they want to manufacture some shoes or a sole for a shoe, they can 3D print that. They want to manufacture some other items for their defense application, they can do. So in that way, one 3D printer can serve the purpose of entire factory. Entire factory setup, you can put in the entire 3D printer setup. So that is going to be the future. You know, nature is this, coral reefs are depleting. It's a huge demand for coral reefs. Once you have the coral reefs in the sea, that will attract the fishes, including alga, crabs, and other fishes also. So research is required. Though these coral reefs are made out of calcium carbonate, a lot of research is required in this field to 3D print the coral reefs. There is one a project is going in our college also, 3D printing of coral reefs. So this coral reefs, they can be 3D printed so that this can be put under the sea. So this will attract the fishes, the crabs, and all these items, so that this will make our environment as clean and green. Right, this nature has taught a lot of lessons for you. One such case is the depletion of coral reefs. So this is again a big research area. And fashionable plasters, you know, due to the accidents, the bones may be broken. So what the doctor, he will do, he will put is the orthopedic cast. Nowadays, instead of this cast, 3D printed casts are coming. Right, so you can see the fashionable plasters. So there is some provision for ventilation. There is some provision for areas which are to be arrested, especially due to the movement of hand or movement of some bones. So that should be arrested. But at the same time, this will have some flexibility for the remaining areas. So this is actually the fashionable plasters nowadays. Plasters, you know, those days plaster paper is there to put, and it's that itself is a big weight. It's very difficult for the patients to carry. Nowadays, option for the to reduce the weight, to optimize the process. So these fashionable plasters are under market. So they will reach in Indian sector in few months. So though this is being practiced in abroad, so these Indian industries are working for that fashionable plasters also. Maybe in another couple of months, we can see a lot of fashionable plasters also. Bionic ears, you know, our normal ear, this can able to hear up to one particular human frequency. So thanks to 3D printing technology for bringing the bionic ears, so we can go beyond the frequency. That is a normal human capability. So once you 3D print that, you'll be able to hear beyond that frequency. So this is actually, though this is developed in Princeton University, it's the entire work is done by Indian researcher. So this will create an ideal ambience for you to hear beyond the particular frequency. So this bionic ear is again a really boon for the Jeff and Chuck. And not only 3D printing is giving from the biological aspects, so the traditional manufacturing process also, right? You can have a design freedom. You know, the idea is to minimize the waste. The idea is to do the optimization. The idea is thereby saving the cost. You can see the chairs, they are made out of fashionable plasters. Plastics, you can see a lot of gaps are there, but they give you attraction and they minimize the weight. A night lamp, a shoe, you can see the shoe type of shoe, the traditional shoe. This you can able to create using 3D printing, and this 3D printing offers you geometric freedom also. You can see this drums, everything you can do using 3D printing. And nowadays, for low volume manufacturing, like your mobile phone cover, you want to have a customized mobile phone cover. You go to a shop, you will purchase a mobile phone cover. So that may or may not suit to your design, to your taste. So you have something on your mind, and your thinking will be ideally translated into your product. This is mainly applicable for low volume manufacturing. So forget about the bulk or the mass production. Some one or two pieces. I want to take some sample, one or two pieces. So some ballots, something you can. You want to have a customized application. That way, you can go for low volume manufacturing. And nowadays, for manufacturing drugs and pharma products, though this is a new thing for Indian industries, however, to make our nation self-reliant, this is the future, right? The capsules or tablets, they also can be manufactured using 3D printing. So don't think that 3D printing automobile components are manufactured, right? 3D printing, people are talking about other than that education is attacking something, whereas industry explanations are different. It is not like that. All the innovations will coming only through the education sectors. So we have big responsibility on that. We need to train our future engineers, our budding engineers, our graduates to meet the expectations of industry. So this is one such example, right? Manufacture of tablets using 3D printing. Cost effective aspect, all these things will be there. But new technologies are coming into market. So faculty members, you should be prepared to take up the responsibility of the new and emerging technologies. Again, this is a very, very interesting application. You know, mother, she'll be interested in knowing the growth of her child, growth of her baby at the pregnancy. In abroad, what they are doing is that a mother, a pregnant lady, she can go to a scan center. After scan, she'll be given a prototype of her growth of her baby in the pregnancy. So the mother, during the pregnancy, she can be able to touch, she can be able to feel growth of her a child. So though this is being banned in India, but this is again going to be a interesting technology. Like mother, she'll be interested in knowing the growth of her child. So thanks to 3D printing technology for making this happen, for making the entire the parents, the mother as a happy. Doctors, for surgical planning, you know, surgery is not an easy task for doctors. Surgery requires a lot of engineering skills also nowadays. Without engineers, it's very difficult for the surgeons. So this surgery for surgical planning, right? Doctors, before going to the operation theater, they need to have a 3D prototype or 3D model of the entire case. So this is one such a case, the twins with their single head. Doctors abroad, they are very successful in carrying a surgery and they have segregated these two children are born with a single head. So believe me, this is possible only with the help of a proper planning. A proper planning is ensured with the help of a 3D printing. How this head function? So what is the real physical structure? So all these things are studied by surgeons before taking the surgery. So again, this is a interesting applications of 3D printing. For children, he or she will be interested in drawing on the wall of your house. Please encourage your children to draw something on the wall. So don't hesitate. That is the ideal platform for the creativity. So case you consider, in this case, the children has drawn something on the wall. So future extraction, this being converted into a CAD model. You can see the 3D scanner. This will extract a visual, and this is converted into a CAD model, and this CAD model can be 3D printed. So this 3D printed, you can see exactly this resembles the drawing drawn by the child. So he or she will be happy also. You're giving is a gift. You are encouraging your child. You are making your child a creative. So in that way, this 3D printing definitely enhances creativity of our students also. A lot of film industries, you might have seen the 3D printing, right? So the Iron Man, the movie called Iron Man, the entire hand or entire parts are 3D printed. So this is a metal matrix. I mean, this is a metal-based 3D print. Entire things are 3D printed. And this is again interesting application for you. The bark of a bird is damaged. It's very difficult for the bird to live without the bark. So what the scientists they have done is that they created an artificial bark. You can go to the picture. Scientists they have created an artificial bark, right? So and they have they're very successful now. From the human to the animal, the organ printing, though this is a theme for this FDP, from the human, how we are taking to the animals, animals and birds also. So here you can see the bark, they are successfully 3D printed, and they are very successful in fitting this bark to the bird. And this is for the construction aspect also, this 3D printers are used for and nowadays used for construction purpose also. And for printing of chocolates, 3D printing is used confectionery and stationery items. This 3D printing has got a lot of potential in the food industry also. Nowadays, a lot of research is happening in the area of composites 3D printing. So dear faculty members, dear researchers, dear PG students or the participants for this Atal FDP, the idea of this FDP is to encourage you to do some research, some projects related to 3D printing. So this is one such area for you to do research, use of composites for 3D printing. Lot of research is happening, the conversion of carbon dioxide into concrete. Now there's a huge requirement for concrete. There's a huge surplus for this carbon dioxide waste. If you're able to convert carbon dioxide into concrete, so this 3D printing will definitely serve the purpose. So of course, researchers who are in this FDP to work on this conversion of carbon dioxide into concrete. And this is a artificial heart, and this artificial heart, again as I mentioned, this is used for dry run before surgery. Doctors, surgeons, they want to see the exact anatomy before they take into surgery. Right? This is a artificial heart, which is done by this 3D printer at Washington, and this is done by a cardiologist named Laura Oliveri. So what the surgeons is they are doing is that any sort of complex surgery, this surgery is really a headache for them. Though they have got lot of they have finished lot of surgery, but the heart functionality, the heart anatomy will be different for each person. To identify the anatomy of the particular person, right, this 3D scanning, 3D printing will definitely help them. So this is the ideal way where we could have encouraged your students to do project also. And this is a car, the entire car is being completely 3D printed. The car called Aston Martin. and they have made this 1:3 scale. Entire things is completely 3D printed. Earphones, you know, always there is a problem in fitting the earphones for your ear. You purchase a earphone, even though you purchase a earphone of say 3,000 or 5,000, it may or may not suit your ear. Right, the ear will be different for each person. So these earphones, they need to be fit correctly on the particular person. So it could be depending on the age or depending on the location. But sometimes what happens is that even for online classes or something, the earphone, some person will be using some different earphones. We can have a customized earphone for your ear. So that's what you're going to do is that a 3D scanner that will scan your ear. This is again converted into a CAD model, right? CAD model is can be completely converted into a product, a earphone using 3D printing. So again, you can give this as for your students' project also. You can encourage your students to do projects in customized 3D printed earphones for their particular ear. Guitars or any musical instruments can also be 3D printed. And this Rolls-Royce car, which is being made, is having 10,000 3D printed parts. And this is again an interesting application. So just a minute, I'll have a glass of water, I'll come back. Please wait. I'll have a glass of water and come back. Okay, right, so I'll continue. Here, nowadays we need to have a 3D scanner. You have to purchase a costly 3D scanner. This 3D scanner has to scan the object. Then only this can be converted into a CAD model. Maybe in another 1 or 2 years, we can have it. A complete 3D scanner is available in our mobile phone also. Using your mobile phone, you can take your photograph, and this photograph is really converted into a CAD model. So, through our computers, we have a lot of applications are there where you can able to convert. But in future, maybe in another 1 or 2 years, all the mobile phones, they will have this option where you can take a photograph. This photograph will be converted into a CAD model. And this CAD model, you can take it for a 3D printing. So this is going to be the future. And here, an interesting thing is that this avoids you the cost of printing also, the cost of scanning also. If you have something on your mobile phone, right, if you're having, you know, everything nowadays is, even students are using for mobile phone also. Even for online learning, students are using mobile phone. Though they have laptops and they have other devices also, it's a very easy for them to carry. So here, students friendly application development for 3D printing is the need of the hour. And not only for developments, all the things, all the edible items can really be 3D printed. You can see there is a company called Fooding, and they are specialist in manufacturing all the food items through 3D printing. Right? You can see from the picture how they are beautifully done, how they have created the food items using 3D printing. They have started to complete a 3D printing restaurant also. And this is again a wandering home called Ameda. And this home is completely 3D printed. It's a zero energy home. Right here, this is, though it's like a caravan, this entire caravan is 3D printed. So you can see the panel at the top side will be having solar, you can have wind energy, that will provide you the necessary power supply for this 3D printed home. It's a mobile in nature. You can go wherever you want. Entire thing is completely 3D printed. Though this is called a 3D printer, it's a home. 3D printed home, right? Though we are talking about the applications of 3D printing, one such area is construction. But this is very special. This is a mobile type of 3D printing. And first 3D printed human is expected by the year 2050. It's called as Ramya. The name is Ramya. It's actually a next generation 3D printer. So what the scientists they are planning is that within 9 days you can be able to 3D print a human. Like people are talking about cloning those days. It's a 3D printed human which will have the source code and designs of all the organs and tissues. You know, entire our body, our organ tissues are playing a vital role. Right? Everything, if you're able to get from the open source, people nowadays are taking through open source only, or a Creative Commons platform, CCP. So entire your body can be made as its parts, and this can be assembled. Right, entire thing you can have here, like what you have a 3D assembly, entire body can be assembled. Just you can click print button, that is sufficient. Entire body will be 3D printed. Research is going on in the area of molecular printing. Molecular printing using 3D printing. You can see from the picture, molecules can be 3D printed. This is again interesting application for you. Nowadays, people are talking about Amazon, people are talking about Flipkart, etc., etc., for their online shopping. In future, what we can do is that you can have a custom-made items. Suppose if your shoe size is say 12, no one can manufacture a shoe size of 11 or 12. In rare cases, the shoe size of 12 is not possible. So what the mechanism is going to be in the future is that you want to have a customized shoe size, say shoe size of 12. You give it to the order. Right? This 3D printer, this will manufacture your products. It could be a single batch, or it could be a say consignment. Say I want to have different colors of 5 shoes, the same size, say size 12. So this order will reach to the 3D printer. And this 3D printer, depending on your requirements, everything will be coming through cloud-based manufacturing. Near future, cloud-based manufacturing will be the buzzword. So your order will be coming through the cloud to the 3D printer. This 3D printer, this will manufacture your shoe, and again, this is taken as a consignment, and this postponement services, they will do the necessary delivery aspect, and this will be delivered. Okay, so scan station, this will scan the product, so that will be connected in a CAD model. Second element is the workstation. So this workstation will do the 3D printing, and third one is the partial shop. So believe me, in all the roadshow shop in 2013 or 2025 in India, in all the roadside shop, you can see a 3D print shop. So this 3D print shop, this will print any components, starting from the small bolt and nut to the entire aircraft assembly. So this is going to be the future of all the manufacturing process, starting with a small product to a bigger or giant element. And you can make the pottery items, the electronic artisan, like the small components, which requires minute efforts, like the artisanship. Believe me, the first 3D printer to take it to space, NASA, they have developed this 3D printer, and they are very successful in taking this to space. You know, the space we have to do the zero gravity experiment, and this, they are very successful in taking this to space. So any components which are on demand, any components which require some special attention, so they can be also 3D printed. And unmanned aircraft vehicles, so all this can be 3D printed. And 3D printer lunar base, and thanks to European Space Agency, and now they are collaborating with architects to see the possibility of using lunar base, which can be 3D printed. So this reduces logistics of settlements from the Earth, and this is will be the future. And all this construction can be done with the help of the local materials which are available. And this is again an interesting application, the fashion retail industry. And you know, the children, they'll be interested in wearing the t-shirts or costumes which are needed, which could be really be interesting, which could be really be fashionable for them. So there is a company called Electrolux. They organize a design competition, and there is a engineer called Joshua Harris. He come up with a plan called manufacture your own cloth. You know, the t-shirts or any items, they can also be 3D printed. So there is a cartridge inside this, and this cartridge will be having different colors and different materials. You go through the picture, you get an idea. Here you can see the printer, like what you have your traditional type of printer. You can print your fashionable items, you can print your dress, you can print your cloth or whatever items. So to fit your size, your environment, your conditions, you can do the 3D printing. And this is not only restricted to new cloth, you can use recycled cloth also. The old cloth you can recycle, they will automatically identify, segregate the things, and you can able to recycle that also, right? Maybe in 2050, we expect all the homes to have a 3D printer like this. This is mainly meant for designing your own cloth, printing your own cloth. Only for design, you can print your own cloths. So this is possible. Maybe in another 10 or 20 years, Joshua's intention is to make this to your home by 2050. But maybe in another 5 to 10 years, we expect a lot of innovations to come into this field. And 3D printed sweets, right? You know, for wedding cakes and for pie toppings, you need to put different sweet. So this will give you an attraction where you can keep it under the pie toppings also. And as you have seen in the cinema movies, or NASA, they got this idea from the movie called Star Trek. So this, the movie, they get the food items. Similarly, here also, at the click of your single button, you can get the desserts. So they'll automatically reach to the persons who is traveling the spacecraft. Whereas if you take for Mars or other applications, the tradition is that to send robots to the Mars. However, if you are taking for a human, how long can the human survive on the Mars without food? It's very difficult for them. So to ensure this, NASA has come up with a plan. They're taking this 3D printer. This 3D printer is mainly meant for giving the food to them. You can see in the NASA, and they are taking this 3D printer, and this validated zero gravity experiments. It's a very very simple type of 3D printer, though this may looks occupying a huge space. It's very very simple 3D printer. It's very easy to operate. This can supply. This can able to produce anything. A single printer will be the future. This is going to be the entire manufacturing process. So this is assembly line of tomorrow. If you see future industries, they don't need anything. What they require is a 3D printer in different configuration, in varying quantities. You can see in a company they are using different varieties of 3D printer. That is sufficient. That is sufficient for long-term production. That is sufficient for them to understand the market requirements, to identify, and then to implement. Now, Chinese nowadays are using the 3D printer for meat production. The meat can also be artificially produced. So this mechanism is very simple, right? You can see a 3D printer attaches there. So this will separate and this will deposit the material accordingly. So you don't need anything, any complex devices or any structure for this. Just a simple deposition of the material, you are able to produce the meat. This pandemic has changed everything. In hospitals last year, in India also, should be very careful in touching the glass doors or keys. So everything, you take a lot of care to avoid the transmission of virus. So what mechanism hospitals have devised is that COVID touch tool is there. So with this touch tool, they can open with the flick of a wrist, they can open the doors for any keys, and again they can able to close that also. And this COVID touch tool is practiced, and they're very successful in avoiding the transmission of virus in hospitals. Last year, there was a huge demand for ventilator. There are some person who traveled from one location to another searching for a hospital which is having a ventilator. So thanks to 3D printing technology, can able to split a single ventilator. This single ventilator can be splitted into two valves. This will provide life to two persons. In the sense, with a single ventilator, this can operate for two or three persons also. The only thing, you need a valve. So that time, last year, 2020, there was a huge demand for valves. So that time, the supply of medical items is not satisfactory. People find very difficult. Even hospitals find very difficult to get these valves to meet the requirements of the patients. This 3D printing technology has changed this entire scenario, where hospitals also can able to produce this valves for ventilator. So not only for valves, during the COVID period, the people, they will take the swabs. There's a demand for swabs also. So for taking the COVID samples, right, this 3D printed nasal swabs were there in the market, and in the hospitals they can produce this nasal swabs, and they can take the swabs of the particular persons. Face masks can also be 3D printed. Last year there was a demand for N95 masks. So this face mask, N95 mask, can also be 3D printed. And door openers, I mentioned. And most important thing is that training and visualization. I'm very happy that a lot of participants from biomedical domain is there. There are a few doctors who registered for this faculty development programs for working medical products also. For biomodels, for making these biomodels as a really interactive and live to students, 3D printing can be used. And ventilator walls can also be 3D printed. And the connectors for the particular mask can also be 3D printed. And people have used 3D printing for producing the PPE. Though India is a country, it has exported a lot of PPE equipments. People of India never realized that we need a lot of PPE equipments. So COVID has changed everything, and India is using, though they are the largest manufacturer of PPE, nowadays PPE equipments, there's a huge demand for PPE equipments also. And 3D printer respirators can also be produced using 3D printing. And metal filters for respiratory devices can also be 3D printed. So this medical applications, where the engineers have to work together as a team with doctors also. You know, doctors nowadays, they have some different agenda. Doctors, they are doing a wonderful job. Doctors during the post-COVID, as well as during the COVID period, they have done a wonderful job. But technology, if you see the technology like organ printing, you need the help of, we have to support the engineers and technologists. They have to support the doctors also. So then only this is possible. So a lot of projects can also be given to the students in the area of 3D printing. In schools and colleges, you can also use 3D printers. This 3D printing has changed the entire classrooms. Majority of faculty members of this faculty development program, right? Even school teachers can also participate in this faculty development program. For biology students, they can study the cross section of heart or other organs. I mentioned for other organs also, they can 3D print. You see, in Singapore and other countries, even in school level, starting with some 6th standard, 7th standard, students are using 3D printing. They will go, they visualize the product, and at the same time, it will be 3D printed. The students can get the 3D print to their home for the study. Whereas in India, we have to put a lot of efforts to make this as a reality. Then chemistry students can print out complex molecules for the study. Engineering students for making the components for robot or assembly for car, they can also use that. Geography students to study about topography, in fact, civil engineering also, to study about topography and population of demographics on a particular area, you can use this 3D printing. Food technology students, I mentioned a lot of applications for this food technology. History students, for history classes, for making models of some animals, some species like that, you can use this. Architectural students can print new design or the existing design. So for making design prototype, nowadays a lot of competitions are going on, even for the school students as well as for college students. If you see, for circuit branches also, for non-circuit branches also, the students have to make some prototype before taking to the real product. Use their brains, students have to do some prototypes. So this prototype is made possible with the help of 3D printing. So though 3D printers are used for the last 25 years, so due to the cost aspect, it is not used. If you see the inception of internet also, Indians, though we are very late in internet field, but if you see the recruitment of the software industries, Indians, they stand very high. Similarly, in 3D printing also, though Indians, you have started very late, we'll be able to scale new dimensions, new heights. And future, we call it a teaching factory. So this is not educational institution, it's a teaching factory where the students will be exposed to manufacturing enterprise. Your students can design anything. Right? Your 3D printer is sufficient. This is a manufacturing enterprise. It's a teaching factory. I like this is the word teaching factory. It's a teaching factory. Students, they will be exposed directly to the manufacturing enterprises. If any industry is available near to, they will come to your location, and you can manufacture according to the needs of the industry. Only thing is that you have to make your public aware of the facilities available to you. You have to create awareness among the public. So this is possible. 3D printing, you can do anything. So that kind of training, that kind of awareness, you have to create. And in future, you have to generate a publicly accessible additive manufacturing facility. So 3D printing or what you call additive manufacturing facility. So this should be accessible to the public, like what you have here, ATM. What do you have, your bank? It's publicly accessible. As I mentioned, the roadside, you can create a three-layered 3D print shop, which is really accessible to all the public. So in that way, a lot of innovations are required in your teaching so that the students will really benefit out of this new and emerging technologies. So, as I mentioned, it's the fourth industrial revolution. And this fourth industrial revolution, the main aim is to minimize the material wastage. So though this is very framed as additive manufacturing, it's not the subtracted type of manufacturing where you keep the material. The material is added layer by layer without any waste, minimizing the consumption of energy. So this is an ideal way to make the products cost effective also. We are talking about Industry 4.0. How the Industry 4.0 can be taken to the industries, even for the small scale industries, how we are going to take organ printing, how the organ printing can really be used for nearby hospitals. This is not restricted to tier 1 cities or metropolitan cities. The idea of this faculty development program is to bring the technologies to rural background also, hospitals also. Lot of hospitals will be available in your location. So how we are going to interpret, how we are going to take the technology to the rural, to the nearby hospitals. So that lies the success of our faculty development program. And research, as I mentioned, you can do research work in the area of new materials for IT manufacturing process, like polymeric materials are there. How the metals are used, what kind of metals can be incorporated in the development of 3D printing, and what mixture of these materials so that the desired biological properties will not be affected. So you need to have biomaterials, biocompatible materials without affecting the human functionality. And then you can work on research area on product design as well as for process design also. Mathematical models can also be predicted, like temperature distribution, stress distribution. So all these things can be part of your research work. So this idea of our faculty development program is to make our faculty members to be aware of the emerging technologies. So thereby, you can take this to your students, your faculty members, and to your institution also. So that's all from my side. So if you have any queries, you can feel free to ask me.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for a wonderful session, sir.